Today, I want to talk to you about stories. But more importantly, I want to talk to you about the stories we tell ourselves. Because it's the stories that we tell ourselves that limit our success. Or they could make our success, but more often than not, they're limiting our success. So hi, I'm Donna Joy Usher from Social Media Bomb. My business partner Steph and I help online coaches and experts set up their automated online client getting machines. So I've been doing a lot of work lately on my mindset, like I'm sure we all are, and I've been playing around with the whole neutral circumstance thing, where basically everything that happens to us is a neutral circumstance, and we need to realize that so that we're in control of the thoughts that we're having about that, and then the resulting emotions, and then from there, how those thoughts and emotions are driving our actions and inactions. And so many of us are caught up in a life of where we're a victim mentality, where we don't realize that the things that are happening to us are actually neutral. We're thinking that they're bad. We're thinking that they're awful, but they're actually neutral. And it's our thoughts about those circumstances that are making them bad or awful. Now, we tell ourselves stories about things, and then we use those stories as excuses for why something can't happen. And we don't realize we're doing it because we are so caught up in thinking that these neutral circumstances are not neutral, that they have a positive or a negative. That when we tell ourselves the story, it's just normal and natural. And when we tell other people the stories, then they get caught up in our story, and to them it's real as well, when in reality it's just a story. So for instance, I heard myself telling a story the other day, and it was so funny because I've been studying the neutral circumstances, and when this story came out of my mouth, and it was a rote answer I'd been giving people, I realized, for years. It was just this easy thing that I'd come up with, that I slung out there, and as the words were coming out of my mouth, part of my brain realized it was just a story, and it was like, I was like horrified. I was like, oh my God, that's just a story. And I was looking around because I thought that people were going to be pointing fingers at me and going, that's just a story. But the funny thing was that I was the only person in the room that realized it for the story that it was. And it was something that I said about my husband's roster, because he's a pilot. He comes and goes and each week's different. And I said, it's impossible to get into a routine, with Michael having the way his roster is. And sure, it's hard to get into a routine, but it's not impossible. And I've been using that as an excuse to not be in routine, and not being in routine doesn't set me up well for the day, because I'm kind of like here and there, and it's more like being in a washing machine and I'm just reacting to things rather than actually being in a routine. And sure, I may never be able to have a 9-to-5 routine or a normal routine that people would have if their spouses were either there all the time or if they were working a 9-to-5 job. But I can have a routine that I set that changes weekly and works around his roster. So I can have a routine that still gets me up at a certain hour and still has me doing my mindset stuff and still has me doing everything, but then I might have a break to spend some time with him and then get into work one day, whereas the next day it might switch. So you can see that my story that I was telling was a total lie that I had told for so many years, and I had believed it, and everybody else around me was still believing it. Now, one of the other stories that I hear people saying all the time that really drives me nuts is, as people are getting a little bit older, maybe even older, they tell this story where, it's a bit late for me. It's a bit late for me now. Like when they're getting older, and you're like, well, my thing is, it's never too late. Never too late to do what you want to do. I mean, when I was working as a dentist, I had a dental student who came and studied with me. She was going through uni, and from the first year of uni, she came and worked with me on her days off. And she was older than me. And so she graduated as a dentist at 43. Okay. Most people at the age of 38, the thought of entering to dental school would say, oh, it's too late for that. I'm too old for that. That would be their story they were telling herself. She did not tell herself that story. And now she's been a dentist for maybe 5 or 6 years, making really good money and enjoying her life. So, you know, people tell themselves stories about that. It's too late for me now, from a health point of view, or from a weight loss point of view, or from a business point of view. And the words that come out of their mouth, it's quick, it's easy, it's a blanket excuse that they get to say that allows them to not put in the hard work or the effort to do what it is that a part of them really wants to do, that a part of them would really want. And everybody else is sitting around going, oh yeah, they are a bit old for that. And they're just gobbling up this story, and they're not calling them on it. Now, most people will not call you on stories because they like that everybody is in the comfort zone with them. because it allows them to be feeling okay about the fact that they're not challenging themselves either, and that they're allowing stories to run their lives and for them to not be living the best life that they possibly could. So I want you to start challenging yourself over the stories that you're telling yourself. And when something comes out of your mouth, stop. When it's just an automatic reaction, stop and really have a look at it and ask yourself, well, is that true? Is that really true for me? Or is that just a story I'm telling myself? And then start to have a think about the things that are happening to you and see that they're really just neutral. They're just things that happen, and that it's you that's giving them the attributions of positive or negative and the emotions that surround them. And if you start to do that, if you can start to break away and see that these things are neutral, then you're going to stop to have these triggers in your life that are just causing these emotions that are then sending you into tailspins. And are the days when you're not running your business, you're not driving your business, you're not doing stuff because of things that are happening to you, and you're going to be in that washing machine like I was when I was talking about my husband's roster. So these are the things that we need to realize and start to take accountability for and start to grow up and be responsible for our lives and for our decisions that we're making and for our actions that we're taking, and stop blaming it with our stories. Okay, I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video.